starting in the eighth row. Another GTA competitor. Number 80, Dan Knox, in that beautiful ACS Manufacturing Performance Speed Tech Viper.
I bought my first kind of performance car back in 2000. It was a Viper, and it was a street car, and I took it to a few racetracks, track days, and practiced around. And next thing I knew, I was buying another car to turn into a race car and started doing some SCCA events locally around my area in Texas, and started that way, and just kind of progressively worked up. And 2005, I got out of racing for about 5-6 years, and my business got really busy, and took an active role in that and growing the business. And two and a half years ago, I bought another car and started racing again, and I ended up with the Pirelli World Challenge.
Watching some of the battlers in the GTA category.
The GTA category, I think, is something that's really special to a lot of the drivers that are non-professional drivers like myself that, you know, have businesses or have other jobs that they're working on, and we get to come in here and compete in our own kind of class and you know, win for some championship, you know, and winning for races as opposed to having to compete with the professional race drivers that also compete with us. So.
And in GTA, guess who pulled it off? What a story. Dan Knox brings the win home in that SRT Street Race Technology Dodge Viper. That is awesome stuff.
That was a great win for the team, our guys that worked so hard, you know, to make this car where it is and get that first win. And then for our, you know, SRT being backing us and the new production car and winning that race in the hometown of Detroit for them, it was great for everybody. We really enjoyed that. About a year ago, we started looking for a new car to run for the Pirelli World Challenge, and we looked at a few different cars, and the car that we chose was the Dodge Viper SRT GT3R car.
Dan Knox, yesterday in his ACS Manufacturing Performance Speed Tech Dodge Viper SRT, got his first win as a rookie in the GTA category, fulfilling one of the reasons that street race technology brought that GT3R to the series.
We're pretty excited about having the GT3R in World Challenge. World Challenge, I think, made a great investment in inviting all the GT3 spec cars kind of unchanged. So it really made our job in SRT easy to bring the car into the series. We think that this is going to be a great series, not only because competition is so close, but the all the different cars that are coming and are here now. One of the things SRT does is they take everything we learn at the track and put it into the production car. It really helps the breed, and I think it makes even the engineers a little bit, you know, more on top of their game when they can bring the information they learn at the track and put it on the street. So the SRT Viper is really a halo car for our SRT brand. We've got, you know, both Dodges, Chryslers, and Jeeps in the brand. And I think even those customers relate to the Viper when they come and cheer for it.
Fabulous choice for us. It's been a great, you know, having the only American car besides the Cadillacs in this series, you know, running in an American race series. So we're really enjoying it.
What's your favorite part about World Challenge?
I think there's a lot of camaraderie in the World Challenge. There's a lot of, you know, the drivers' signings, you know, that we have. Just the competitiveness of the series itself. It's a very, very great series to be in. I mean, the car counts are tremendous. You know, you got a lot of challenge with all the cars passing everything else that goes on in the races with the World Challenge. It's great. When I'm not racing, I'm busy with a manufacturing engineering firm that I own and running it and building and growing it as well. So, and as well as my family. My wife is into horses, so I get to do horse racing as well as car racing. So it's very, very challenging and exciting time-wise as well.
Who do we have to thank?
Right now, we have to thank ACS Manufacturing, my business, that's helping sponsor this run for us and all the exciting times we have here at the World Challenge. I'm probably one of the least experienced drivers, I would say, in the series. And I think give myself a few more years, and we'll see if we can't move up. And, you know, we're looked like try to find some sponsorship to go along and get another car running with our team, and have a GTA class drivers running in us. And eventually, maybe I could get to the point where I'm competing with the GT drivers and winning the podium and some money.